The angle addition postulate is very similar to the segment addition postulate. If we were to add two pieces of any angle, together their measures must equal the whole angle. Supplement theorem says that if you have two angles that are a linear pair, then they are supplementary angles. Similarly, the complement theorem says if you have two adjacent angles that make a right angle, then those two angles are complementary angles. The reflexive, symmetric, and transitive properties all hold true for the congruence of angles. Additionally, angles that are either complementary or supplementary to the same angle are congruent. Finally, vertical angles are always congruent. Four right angles. Any two perpendicular lines intersect to make four right angles. All right angles are congruent. Perpendicular lines form congruent adjacent angles, since the adjacent angles will both be 90 degrees. If two angles are congruent supplementary, then they are each right angles. Since if they are supplementary, they must equal 180 degrees. If they are congruent, that means they must both be the same, which means they both must be 90. Hence, they are right angles. If two congruent angles form a linear pair, then they are right angles. If they form a linear pair, they create a line, which supplement theorem says they are supplementary. Again, if they are congruent and supplementary at this point, the only way that they could be 180 degrees and be congruent is if they are both 90. Hence, they are right angles. Find the measure of the missing angle. Knowing if angle 2 is 67 degrees, we know that angle 1 plus angle 2 must equal 180 degrees. Since they are a linear pair, the supplement theorem tells us that they are together equal to 180 degrees. Since angle 2 is 67, that means that measure angle 1 must be 113 degrees in order for them to be supplementary. Angles 3 and 4 are vertical angles, which means they are congruent, which means as measures, they are equal. So if the measure of angle 3 is 2x plus 7 and the measure of angle 4 is x plus 30, they must be congruent. Then, upon solving for x, you will see that in this case, x ends up equaling 23. We must be reminded that they asked to find the measures of the angles. Since, in this case, these angles are vertical, they must be the same. So by finding the measure of angle 4 to be 53 degrees, that must also mean that the measure of angle 3, since they are vertical, is also 53 degrees.